Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. You know how you can press F1 on, say, QList or QVector or whatever you want in Qt, and you can jump right to the help pages? Wouldn't it be cool if we could do that with C++ pages too? Well, you can. Let me show you. Voila! So how was that possible? Pretty simple. I went to this page. There are a link that you can click on below here. And I went down to Qt Help Book and I downloaded this zip file. I unzipped the file, put it somewhere nice on my hard disk. Then in Qt Creator, I went to Tools, Options, Help, Documentation, and I chose Add. I specified this file that I had downloaded there, press Open, and it's already registered because I already had it in there, so I won't do anything else. Otherwise, it would have been adding it. And now I have it available in here. And I can look up anything I want. So Control K, for example, works too. Question mark, unordered set. If I, for some reason, want that, it's here anyway. There's a few tricks to learn. First of all, over here in this content, you'll be able to see a C++ standard library reference. And if you open it up here, you can see lots of interesting stuff. That's the front page. Very good to have that available. So let's add a bookmark to that. Go up here, bookmark, C++ reference. Well, just front page. And as you can see, I already have a bookmark on one of the other ones that I love very much to go and look at from time to time. Well, love, that might be an exaggeration. I can't remember everything, so I'll look it up from time to time, namely the algorithms. And here is all the algorithms of the C++ template library. And if I someday want to look at exactly what was it exactly the generate did again, question mark generate. And there we are. Is it the Q random generator? Okay, so question mark std :: generate. And why do I see it three times? See, that's a good question, but not for me to answer because I don't have a good answer. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. I hope this small trick was useful to you. Give me your thoughts in the comments below. Maybe you have an ultimate killer trick when it comes to Qt Creator, Qt Designer, anything. Let me know. It might be worthwhile sharing that with everybody else, and I'll gladly make a video out of it if I can figure it out. Thank you very much. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB.